Pow, what's up everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and today someone asked me, how do you get the most out of remixes and cover songs? So I've broken it down into 5 simple steps. Number 1, identify a song. Now there's 2 things you want to keep in mind when you do this song for the purposes of getting more views and growing your audience. 1, you want it to be most likely a more current song. We can get into the details of that a little bit later. But the second thing that I want to keep in mind for identifying a song is your best bet is to make the song a song that resonates with your audience. So that means if a lot of your fans are probably Kendrick Lamar fans too, then you probably want to remix some of his songs that are popping and trendy, or any artist under that umbrella. Whoever the potential fan base that you're trying to capture is already a fan of, remix some of their popping songs. It's going to help you because they are obviously already looking for that music, which again we'll get to at the end. Number 2, release it in a timely manner. And number 3, make sure you mention the title of that song in the title of your description when you post it on YouTube. You can put remix in parentheses, you can put your name after whatever the title of the song is and then remix. There's small nuances and ways you can do it, but I would go for name a song, remix parentheses, your name as the best bet, most likely. And before I go to 4 and 5, I wanna go ahead and touch on why it's so important to have the right title, to have it released in a timely manner, and to have a song that's trendy at the time. When a song is trendy, that means a lot of people are looking for it. They are searching for that song. And there's this thing called SEO, search engine optimization. So when people are searching for something, there's gonna be all of these similar possibilities that are likely to be what they're searching for. That's how you find stuff on Google. That's how you find songs that you're looking for. When a song is new, more people are searching for it. You have to release it in a timely manner because the faster that you release that song, the less competition there's going to be when people search for it. They'll have probably the original song that they were actually looking for and then your remix. But then the more time that passes by, there's going to be more people that do their remixes. There's going to be more people that mash up their original song, or they just post the original song on their page because they want the views on their page. All those things start to become a competition. And if you don't have a huge following already, the pages with bigger followings are going to get more views faster naturally, and that's going to start pushing yours lower and lower because the way YouTube algorithm works. Although your video doesn't have to have the most views to be the top ranked, but that's a whole nother conversation. And lastly, you need to have that song name as the title because people are probably going to search for the title of the song. And that's how the search engine optimization works, right? They're looking for that song. You have the same title of that song. That video pops up. There's some additional places that you can place that information, which we'll go over in 4 and 5, but YouTube by far puts the most weight on the title itself. Now moving on to number 4, put the song title, put the name of the other artist, put your name, all of that in the description because you want that to just be an additional thing that gets picked up. And then number 5, pretty much the exact same thing. Put that song name in the description, put that other artist in the description. You can even put a few of the other artist's songs in the description with their name next to it. For example, if you did a remix of Kendrick Lamar's Be Humble, you would put Kendrick Lamar Be Humble, but you also might put Kendrick Lamar Swimming Pools in that description, whatever. It won't have a huge effect, but sometimes those things add small benefits. But of course, also you wanna put your name because you want it to be found in the future by using your name in that tag section as well. There's multiple artists who have done this to blow up and get a lot of attention. And not only that, there's artists like Joyner Lucas, who's considered to have a strong fan base himself, still drops remixes just to get a little bit of attention and insert himself into conversations with trendy songs. So wanted to keep this video super simple for you guys. If you have any questions, go ahead and ask it in the comment section below. But other than that, if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.